how to configure the virtual machine in our Azure portal, as well as how to create a customized VPC VNet connection. Okay, so first I will open my Azure portal account. Okay, so here for what is our scenario means. So first what I want to do, first I want to create a, okay, so create a one VNet. Okay, in this VNet I will create a two subnet, one and a subnet two. So then you can create other resource like VM machine. Okay, so this VM machine I will map to the my first subnet. Okay, so this is my scenario. Afterwards, how to assign the security group? Okay, then how to create a NAT and how to create a peering later on we will see. Now first we will create a one VNet, and a VNet we have the two subnets here. Then you can map to the first subnet to your VM machine. Okay, so go to the Azure portal, go to the first one. We want to create a resource group, so go to the resource group. So go to the resource group, create a new resource group. Okay, here we have the subscription. What is the subscription here? Free tier subscription and a resource group. I will give the resource group name is demo. Demo 1, I will give the resource group. Then I will choose the location, same east location. Okay, give create. And create a resource group. Why? Because of the resource group is managed your resources actually. Okay, go to the home, and second thing you want to create a virtual network now. So virtual network, go to the new virtual network. Okay, same, I want to map the subscription here. Okay, so the free tier subscription is available. Then we want to map the resource group. Here I will map the resource group like demo.1. I will give the name. What is the name is? VNet1. So give the same region, or else if you change the region also, this scenario I will give the same region. You create. So go to the previous. So here first one basic, then go to the IP addressing. So the IP addressing, so I want to create my customized IP address. So what is the customized IP address means? 192.168.0.0/16. Okay, this is my subnet, this is my VNet ID. Then you can create a same ID for this range. Okay, so go to the adding the subnet here. So I will add at the 192.168.1.0/24. Okay, sorry, we want to mention the name here. So I will give subnet 1, then give 192.168.1.0/24. Okay, then you can add the subnet now. Okay, so again I will add at the other subnet. So give subnet 2 and give IP address 192.168.2.0/24. okay, they give add. Okay, so we have created the two subnet in this range of 192.168.0.0. Then give second security. So you have the three type of the security here. The firewall security, DDoS protection standard security, bastion and host security. So I am not enable any security. Why? Because of if you enable the security means you want to give the credential for the security. Okay, in this case we are the demonstration, we are not giving the any security here. Give next tag and give the create now. So now this validation is passed. Now you can give create. So once your virtual network is created means, then what is our scenario? Okay, so this network you want to map with the VM now. Okay, so that is a very important thing. Okay, so go to the resources. So go to the resources VNet 1, and here we can get the all the resources available in your virtual network. So for go to the subnets. So settings, you can get the subnet, you can give the subnet. So which we are created the subnet here, we can able to see. Okay. So then, so same thing, we want to create a other resource in the same resource group. So what is other resource means? Virtual PC. Okay. So so go to the more services. So more services, go to the compute service. So the compute service, you have the n number of the services here. So I will select the virtual machine. So go to add the virtual machine, add new virtual machine. So you want to create a virtual machine now. So save free tier eligible, and we want to mention the demo.1. Okay, you can give the your virtual machine name. I will give the server web. So same location, East US. So then you can give the image, what image you want to create now. So I want to create a 2016 data center edition. Okay, so then what you want to do, you want to allocate the size of the space. Okay, so which size you want to create now. So I will size, which size means standard DS1 V2 size I will create it now. So why? Because of it is the standard one. Okay, it is a recommended by the publisher. Okay, so monthly cost, if you using this one monthly base means it will around take, it will take 6626 value. Then I will give the name. So admin ROM. Okay, so username is admin ROM. Then I will give the password here. Okay, same, I can give the password here. Okay, so here you want to mention the port. Okay, so I want to select the port is RDP port. Then you want to select the disk type. What type of the disk you want to select? Okay, disk type, I want to select the HSD. Okay, so then you can give the network. So this is the very important. So here you want to mention the which network you want to create. Okay, so we have the two network. One is the demo.1, another one is a VNet1. Okay, go to the demo.1. So VNet1, I will create the VNet. So see, we can get the subnet. So here we can get the two subnet. So I will connect it to the subnet 1. Okay. So the public IP, it is automatically created by the, given by the Azure. Okay. So then we want to give the NIC code as basic one. We want to give advanced one means advanced one also you can able to give. So here I will give the basic one. Okay, then go to the management. So the management enable the storage account, enable the custom storage, disable. Okay, so I will give the managed storage account recommended. Okay, so don't give anything. Okay, then go to advanced one. So advanced, you want to give the custom data. For example, you want to do the any process in your virtual machine. Here itself, you can write the script like a PowerShell script or shell script. You can able to use here. So what are the things you want in your virtual machine? Okay, so here itself you can able to give. So here I am not using anything. So give tag to create. So the review and the creation. They are checking now. So how much cost it will come means around per hour it will cost 9 rupees. Okay, per hour it is cost 9 rupees, but we have the amount like 14,486 amount. Okay, so the free tier eligible to not issue for us. Okay, so give create now. Once created your virtual machine, you can get the virtual machine console now. Okay, through the console you can able to access the virtual machine. Okay, so it is deploying the process. Okay, when the deploy session is over, you can able to access the virtual machine. See, we are now is deployment. Deployment is processing now. So Windows Server 617 is created. Server IP also created. NetNest group is automatically they will take actually. Okay. Once is created, go to the resources. Okay, so you can go to the resources means you can get the this dashboard. Okay, this is actual dashboard of your virtual machine dashboard. So you can get the all the detail of your virtual machine. Okay, your virtual machine properties. Okay, then you can get the IP address of your virtual machine. What is the size of your virtual machine? Okay, disk space. Okay, so all the things you can able to get here. So we want to connect the this virtual machine. How to connect? There is having a two option. One is here you can able to connect, as well as you can able to connect here itself. So see here, if you can click connect, so there is having an option here. So which option you want to access this one? I give RDP connection. So once you can RDP connection, it is automatically it will give the RDP file. Okay, download the RDP file. Okay, go to the RDP. So go to connect. So it is asking the password. So what is the username I given there? Same thing I want to give here. So what is the username there? User. User. Admin. So give a sticking. Give correct username and password only you can able to connect here. So my maybe my username is admin ROM. Okay, give password. Okay, so we can get the credential, then give yes. Now this session is connecting now. Okay, once a session is connected means we can connect it to your Windows server here. So see how our server is connected here. Okay, so Windows 2016 server, now we are connected. So whatever you want, you can able to do in your Windows server. Okay, so this is how to create a virtual machine with customized VNet. Okay, so thank you.